I have an observation and a question. The observation is about the Singapore kindness movement. I've been under the impression that Singa, the courtesy lion, actually resigned or stepped down 2 years ago. So is there still such a movement in Singapore? So it's, so I read it in the newspaper. So. Secondly, the question then is this. You have presented a number of interesting measures, interesting particularly to an educator. And those are the Culture Compliance Index, the Vision Compliance Index, the Mission Attainment Index. So now from the point of view of a researcher who wants to make sure that any measurements that we made are reliable and valid, how did you measure those?
All the measurements, we have backup papers to support. The Vision Compliance Index methodology came in one of the publications from the McKinsey, who did a detailed study of nearly more than 200 schools and ranked Singapore as the best education for schools in the world. So they published the formulas. In that, it is not a measure, it is only an indicator. Because education itself doesn't have measures. Everything is only an indicator. So in the absence of having anything, we have certain indicators. And Vision Compliance Index is calculated on us. All students, all subjects average, multiplied by the values index, multiplied by if we have the sustainability index, namely the health index and the safety index. Similarly, Culture Compliance Index is based on 35 parameters and evaluated and improved over a period of time.
Thank you for your presentation. Quick question. You mentioned that in the last 10 years, you've been winning a lot of awards all over, not just in Singapore, also the ABTO, for example. What are the lessons learned and you share with your stakeholders in order to improve this benchmark in the world?
Though we are at the top of one mountain, we always feel at the bottom of the second mountain. So that keeps us driving, and on an average last year we won 14 Marco Polo awards. And for you, for the indices, how they are calculated, here is a book which I can give, pass it on to you. No, this is a different one. This is on the measurement of happiness index.
Thank you very much.
That is on this curriculum, this is on happiness.
It's interesting to learn to teach the small students to participate in this. What was their feedback? Did you measure how? But are they happy about doing this? Was it like another burden for them? Did they enjoy it? Did you measure this?
I request that we have one school in. We have recently started a school in Abu Dhabi. On the first day, we crossed more than 100% admissions. For 500 seats, we had more than 3,000 applications. This is our market image. And we taught the children, leaving the toilet very clean is an act of kindness to the next person who enters the toilet. Now we have received letters from the parents stating that their children are refusing to use the toilet in their houses. They want you to come to the school to use the toilets. Singapore is known for the beautiful toilets. We not only won the best toilet award in Singapore, but also we got the best toilet award in the world, and they recently concluded one of the award functions here in Dubai. We received it from His Highness Al-Nayan for the best toilets in the world. Of course, I saw much better toilets also, but for the children to maintain it was really great. So they enjoy. Even on holidays, we no need to take attendance. They even during holidays, they come to the school. Because we do teacher-student mapping. The learning styles we find out, and the match with the teaching styles. So they enjoy. So that's why the happiness index has gone up from 75 4 years ago to 92% today. Happiness index we measure consistently. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.